Welcome back student in basic chemistry course. In previous session, we are going to discuss our third unit, that is paint, varnishes, insulators, polymer, adhesive and lubricants. In that unit, we discuss the topic paint, varnishes and insulators. So in today's session, we are going to discuss the next topic of this unit is the polymers. Okay. So this polymer word which is obtained from the Greek word that is plastikos. This word is obtained from the Greek word plastikos. Plastikos means the fit for molding. And also this polymer means, poly means many and mers means unit. So large number of units which unite together to produce the polymers. Okay. So it is a material which has capacity to get deformed the shape under pressure. That is, it possesses the property of plasticity. So polymers means it is one of the type of plastic. Okay. So this material which is obtained from in different shape, or they acquire in different shape under the pressure. So that's why they get the polymer. Okay. So nowadays different plastics have a number of traditionally used materials such as various metals and ceramics. And these polymers or the plastic is used for the production of various articles such as buckets, pipes, fabrics, bowls, bags and toys. So that means in all products we will used in domestic as well as in industrial purposes, they are made by the polymers. So all the modern industries are also using the polymers for the construction of printed circuit boards, for electronic instruments, and also they will used the polymers for making computers, radio, televisions and automobiles. Okay. So the use of plastic is so common in today's life. So the definition of this, proper definition of this polymer is, it is synthetic organic material. It is a synthetic organic material having high molecular weight, which can be molded into any desired form when subjected to heat and pressure in presence of catalyst. म्हणजेच या डेफिनेशनमध्ये त्यांनी सांगितलंय की पॉलिमर्स जे आहेत हे कशा प्रकारे प्रिपेअर केले जातात, त्यासाठी कोणत्या कंडिशन्स लागतात. मग पॉलिमर्स जे आहेत हे एक प्रकारचे सिंथेटिक ऑर्गॅनिक मटेरियल्स आहेत. त्याचबरोबर पॉलिमर्स जे आहेत यांच्यामध्ये लार्ज नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्युलर युनिट्स हे युनाइट झाल्यामुळे जो पॉलिमर प्रिपेअर होतो आहे इट विल बी हॅविंग अ हाय मॉलिक्युलर वेट अँड दे कॅन बी मोल्टेड इन टू एनी डिझायर्ड फॉर्म. आणि त्याचबरोबर आपण ह्या पॉलिमर्सला कोणत्याही आकारात, कोणत्याही शेपमध्ये प्रिपेअर करू शकतो बाय अप्लाईंग द हीट अँड प्रेशर ऑन इट. ज्यावेळी त्यांच्यावर आपण हीट आणि प्रेशर अप्लाय करतो आहे देन दॅट टाइम्स द पॉलिमर्स विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन डिझायर्ड शेप अँड साईज. ओके. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ पॉलिमर्स. सो दिस पॉलिमर्स, सो let's see what is the polymerization process. So polymerization, it is the process of uniting or linking together a large number of small molecules to form a large molecule under a specific conditions of temperature and pressure and also the catalyst. This process is known as the polymerization. So in this process we unite or link a large number of small molecules. These small molecules which come, these small molecules which unite together to produce the large molecule under specific conditions of temperature, pressure and catalyst, then that times the polymer will be produced and the formation of polymer, this process will be called as the polymerization. Okay. So these polymers will be made by a small molecules. These small molecules will repeated regularly in that structure of polymers. So these small molecules will be called as the monomer. So let's see about the monomers. So the monomer means it is made up of a small molecules. Monomer is the small molecule. For example, we take here one of the polymer is polyethylene. In this polyethylene, the structure of polyethylene is CH2 CH2. This is the structure of polyethylene. In that polyethylene structure, this CH2 CH2 unit is the ethylene. okay? So this ethylene will be repeated regularly in the structure, okay? I write here is the n number of this unit will be repeated regularly in the structure of polyethylene. So one unit is the ethylene. This ethylene will be repeated regularly in that structure of polyethylene. So that's why this ethylene, this is one unit of ethylene. This is the monomer of that polyethylene. This is the monomer unit. That means this small unit or this small molecule which is repeated in that structure. So that's why this small unit, one small unit will be called as the monomer. So these hundreds or thousands of monomer will join together to produce a large molecule in polymer. Okay. So this is about the monomer. So next we see about the classification of polymers. So these polymers will be classified into three types on the basis of their monomers, on the basis of their molecular structure, and on the basis of their thermal behavior. These polymers will be classified into three types. So first type is on the basis of monomers. So the monomers will be present in the polymer. On that monomers, these polymers will be classified into two types. First type is the homopolymer, second type is the copolymer. Second classified type of polymer is on the basis of molecular structure. On the basis of molecular structure, the polymers will be classified into different types. That means the linear polymers will be produced, also the branched polymer will be produced, also the cross-linked polymers will be produced. So these three types will be based on the molecular structure will be present in the polymer. Third classified type of polymer is on the basis of thermal behavior. Thermal behavior of polymer also classify this polymer into two types. First type is thermosoftening polymer and second type is thermosetting polymers. So we discuss these types one by one. So firstly we discuss the on the basis of monomers. The polymers will be classified into two types. First type is homopolymer and second is the copolymers. So firstly we discuss about the homopolymer. So homopolymer means this is a polymer which consists of all identical monomers are known as homopolymers. In this word of homopolymer, homo means same and polymers. So that means identical monomers or identical or the same monomer unit repeated in the structure of polymer which produce the homopolymer. Okay. For example, we will take here is the polyethylene. That means this is one of the monomer, this is another monomer. These monomers will be linked in a large number of molecules and produce the structure of the homopolymer. So we take here example is the polyethylene. In that polyethylene structure, CH2. So this is the structure of polyethylene. In that polyethylene structure, this CH2 unit or the monomer will repeated regularly in the structure of polyethylene. So that's why this is the homopolymer, because the same monomer unit will be repeated in the structure of polymer. So that's why this polyethylene or another example is the polystyrene, they will be the homopolymer. Second type is the copolymer. So the copolymers, this is a polymer which consists of the monomers of different chemical structures. Monomers of different chemical structure, they are linked together in a large numbers. Then that times the polymer is produced will be called as the copolymer. In that copolymers, there is having the monomers of different chemical structures. Manjes copolymers madhe ka ahe? Je monomers join zhalele ahet polymer structures madhe, te monomers जे आहेत हे डिफरंट आहेत. म्हणजे फॉर एग्जांपल इथे स्ट्रक्चर पाहत आपण जनरल स्ट्रक्चर कोपॉलिमर्स. दिस इज वन टाइप ऑफ मोनोमर वी विल राइट हियर एज एज M1. अनदर मोनोमर यूनिट विल बी राइट एज M2. सेकंड इज M1 आल्सो M2. सो दिस M1 अँड M2 स्ट्रक्चर विल बी रिपीटेड रेग्युलरली इन दॅट स्ट्रक्चर. दॅट मीन्स दीज मोनोमर्स आर नॉट सेम, दे आर डिफरंटली लिंक टुगेदर. Okay, so that's why this polymer will be called as the copolymer. For example, styrene butadiene rubber, which shows the copolymer. So let's see the structure of the styrene butadiene rubber. So this is the structure of styrene butadiene rubber. So this is the structure of styrene butadiene rubber. In that structure, we will see here. So in that structure, we see here, this is the styrene and this is the butadiene. Okay. So this styrene is the M1 structure, butadiene is M2 structure. So here is styrene is also M1 structure, so butadiene is M2 structure. Okay. So we see here this M1 unit will be attached to the M2 type of monomer. This M1 type of monomer is linked to the M2 type of monomer. Again, this M2 will be linked to the M1 type of monomer. Again, they will be linked to the M2 type of monomer. So that type, this styrene butadiene rubber containing, this is the one monomeric unit of the styrene butadiene rubber, but this one monomeric unit contains the two structures. Okay, so that's why these monomers of different chemical structures will be repeated in all over the structure of styrene butadiene rubber. So that's why this type of polymer will be the copolymer. So this is all about the polymer and the classified types of the polymer on the basis of monomers. So today we stop here. In next video we discuss classification of polymer on the basis of molecular structure and thermal behavior. Thank you.